Hey guys, today's video will be a little bit unusual. The thing is, I collaborated with Explosion and Fire channel, so make sure you watch all the video so you can see very cool chemical reactions. Look at this ampoule, it contains 20 ml of boron tribromide. This yellowish liquid smokes in the air very actively, forming fog from hydrogen bromide. Reacting with water forms a significant amount of gaseous hydrogen bromide. Concentrated sulfuric acid oxidizes boron tribromide to bromine element. These dark red particles got there from the cap that kept the bottle with the reagent closed. The resulting transparent glassy mass consists mainly of boric acid, and the emitting gas bubbles are sulfur dioxide. Let's heat the tube to see the formation of elemental bromine better. Boron tribromide and concentrated alkali solution are incompatible, so let's add a drop of concentrated potassium hydroxide to boron tribromide. I think you know this classic experiment where ammonia vapors form white smoke when it contacts with hydrogen chloride or hydrogen bromide vapors. And since hydrogen bromide is formed during the hydrolysis of boron tribromide, I decided to add it to the concentrated ammonia solution. Yeah, we didn't get that much smoke as in the reaction with titanium tetrachloride. At first glance, boron tribromide does not react with sodium or potassium under normal conditions. It does not interact with boron sodium either. However, if a few drops of this substance are applied to the surface of these metals, a shock-sensitive mixture will be formed. Try to explain the observed effect in the comments. I think you know this trick where boric acid is dissolved into ethanol, is set on fire and then burns with a green flame due to the formation of triethyl borate. However, boron ethyl ether is also formed during the reaction of borontribromide with ethanol. This reaction is not very impressive, but let's see what happens if we replace ethanol with methanol. You can see methanol ignites spontaneously during the reaction with borontribromide. The color of a flame can become saturated if you take more borontribromide. Yeah, borontribromide is a really cool reagent, and I have made another very cool reaction with it that I'm absolutely sure you haven't seen anywhere else. Now, this is a reaction between borontribromide and molten lithium hydride. In this reaction, lithium hydride reduces borontribromide to poisonous gas that self-ignites on air diborane. I kindly presented all the footages with this reaction to my colleague Camtuba Tuom from Explosions and Fire channel. This is a very captivating channel where you can find liquid ozone, sulfur tetronitrite, and a more recent cool reaction with borontribromide. Be sure to watch the video about it on the channel, where is also a lot of other awesome chemistry content waiting for you to check it out. And if you like it, make sure to like, comment, subscribe. This will help both of us to create even more fascinating videos full of chemistry. Thanks for watching, guys. See you next year.